from the majestic scenes of the Ozark Mountains to the lush farmlands at the entrance to this natural wonderland. It's time once again to discover Arkansas's Ozark Gateway Region. A weekly look at the people, places, sights, and sounds that make up one of the most scenic, rustic, and unspoiled regions of our great country. Now, here's your host for Discover Arkansas Ozark Gateway Region, Doug DeForest and Laura Crowley.
Hi, folks, and welcome to Discover Arkansas's Ozark Gateway Region. I'm your host, Doug DeForest.
And I'm Laura Crowley.
I bet you're wondering where we're going today.
Where are we going?
We are actually going down to Independence County, Batesville, Arkansas, which is one of Arkansas's oldest cities.
Fantastic.
On the White River. So, folks, come on with us today to Independence County, right here in Discover Arkansas's Ozark Gateway Region. Don't you go away.
Now is the time to start planning your vacation getaway and see the sights of the natural state. Visit OzarkGateway.com for your free vacation planner. From relaxing fishing trips and fun on the lake, state parks and historic sites, to exciting festivals, cultural venues and events, museums, caves and caverns, there's something for every member of the family. Visit OzarkGateway.com for your free visitor's guide today. Ozark Gateway, great vacations at affordable prices.
Doug, this place is so full of history.
It is. It's amazing.
It is.
I mean, if you're a NASCAR fan, this is a place to be right here, folks. It's in Independence County, Arkansas. We're right near Batesville, between Batesville and Southside. It's Mark Martin's Museum. Isn't it great?
It's wonderful. There's so many trophies. There's so many,
so much memorabilia.
You got cars everywhere. It's fantastic.
And you know, from the time that Mark Martin climbed into his 1955 Hunter Orange Foremost car out here at the racetrack, racing has changed forever. And Mark Martin has become one of the leaders in the sport.
Yes, he has.
And now that he's back home, he's taken Batesville by the reins and he's building all kinds of great things. We're going to get with, he has a guy here that's going to take us on a little tour.
Wonderful.
Show us all the things that we need to see and tell us a little bit more about Mark Martin's great career.
Awesome.
Let's find our tour guide now, okay?
Let's go.
You know, when it comes to racing, Mark Martin's one of the best. So leave it to him to find one of the best guys around to show us around this great museum. Just a couple turns around the racetrack of this racing legend shrine, and we found the best tour guide you can find.
Hey folks, today we are joined by Mr. Mooney Starr from Batesville Motor Speedway.
That's right. Mooney seems to know everything about this place. We've been talking to him, and I'm so glad he's our tour guide. Mooney, how are you today?
Oh, I'm doing great. I'm glad you are here.
Well,
great place.
Tell us how Mark got his start and why he's back home. You know, a lot of people say you can't go home, and I don't think Mark believed in that at all.
Oh, no, he didn't. And if you once you come here, you can see that.
Mm-hmm.
He wanted to get back in the car, get in the car business, and Rick Hendricks has got lots of car dealerships, and he was talking to Mark, and he said, Mark, if you'll build that thing in Memphis or Little Rock, he said, I'll go partners with you. I'll pay for all of them, give you half. You're out nothing. Mark said, I want to do it in Batesville. He said, you can't build something like that in Batesville financially and support it. And Mark said, I don't care. It's where I'm from. That's what I want to do. And January the 4th of 2004, we opened, and 10 years later, we're still rolling, and our business is phenomenal.
Well, now you're in six different locations and different car companies.
Right, we've got pretty much different brands, and we got a Kia, we got a Chevrolet, Buick, GMC. We got a couple buy here, pay here lots. So, mm-hmm. We've got North Central Arkansas covered if you need an automobile.
Now, tell us a little bit about this car behind us. How much do you know about the IROC?
This is the IROC car. This is when he won the $1 million, and I don't know if you can zoom in back there, but there's the $1 million back there. We've got full-time security here.
Now, y'all gonna say, who printed that $1 million?
I will tell you what's unique about this car is Mark is very particular with his cars, just like a lady is with her shoes,
uh-huh.
You know? If you'll notice the tire on the car,
mm-hmm.
This is when it come off the track, and he was excited and he won $1 million. He said, I want this car put up, don't touch it. And it's never been touched. And you can literally wipe it, and you can see where someone stuck their finger over there, and clean it up. But that's right off the racetrack, right where he won it, and it's exactly the way it is. In fact, his gloves and helmet are still in there, the gloves are on the dash. So when he got out of the car, he was excited and said, don't touch it.
So he literally will never clean this car.
Oh, it's never been cleaned. And he is a clean, neat freak.
Yeah.
But this car has never been cleaned.
I've worked with Mark a couple times. I've never seen a hair out of place. I'll tell you that.
No, he's very particular, and he's everything's got to be so-so.
Now, what are Mark's future plans besides just the car business? Do you have any idea what he's going to be up to?
No, actually, I think he's going to have to do something because he's bored.
Yeah.
You know, he's kind of lived that life, jet set and go, go. And now it's just come out here and check on us. And
yeah.
We got to get him something to do. You know, we don't like bosses around. We like his work, you know.
Well, and now tell us about when he first started. Now, you own the racetrack now, Batesville Motor Speedway.
Yes, sir.
Where he was.
Yeah, he actually started there. It was originally in 71. It closed down a few years. And then my brother and I revived it in 91. And my wife and I bought him out in 93. But yeah, that's where he started racing, right out here at Locust Grove, Arkansas. And I'm not bragging, we took it a long way.
You remember what year he won his first race?
I could go over here and look at one of these books.
I know. I'm going to say it was around 74 or 75, just by doing my math off the things I'm seeing.
That sounds pretty close.
Now, take us around, if you don't mind, and show us the original, the replica of the original car. There's not many replicas in here. Most of the things are the original.
Actually, I'm going to blow you out when I tell you, but that's not a replica. That's actually the car.
Wow. Let's go take a look at it.
All right.
Just one hard bank to the left, past all the photos, memorabilia, and fantastic trophies Mark Martin's won over the years, and you run into the Hunter Orange car that Mark Martin won his first race in so many years ago.
Doug, here's that orange car you were talking about.
Yeah, Hunter Orange with a Foremost seal. I used to drink Foremost milk. It ain't been around a long time.
No, it hadn't.
Now, tell us a little bit about this car and how you found it, because this is the original race car.
This actually is. This car was found over in around Tuckerman, Arkansas, out in the field, trees growing up in it and around it and through it. And we'd done a little research, Mark, so go back and look and see if it's got this and this, and a couple little things that he would know. And actually, this is it. So the gentleman that had it knew what he had. He said, that's Mark Martin's car, and he kind of wanted a price for it. So we sent a couple people trying to negotiate a little bit. Finally got it and had it restored. But let me tell you something that's going to blow you out in here. Every car in here is race ready.
Really?
These cars in here, and that's why I told you a while ago that Mark's a little bit crazy on, you know, making
detail.
This perfect detail. He had these cars, a lot of the motors completely rebuilt, and then they sat in here and they just sat. Why he done it, I don't know. His money, do what he wants.
Yeah.
But these cars are not hulls. These are not frames. These are race ready.
Pull them
race
apart,
cars.
They're ready to go.
They're ready to go. Wow. Most of them, we can put a battery on them, put fuel in them, and take them out here and run them.
My goodness. So, what are your hours here at the museum? Because I want people to be able to come see all these great trophies and cars. It's amazing.
The museum hours are from 8 to 5:30, Monday through Friday, and then Saturday we're from 9 to 5.
Okay.
Free admission, never have charge and don't want to charge. Just want people to come. And here's what I brag about. If you're a race fan, it's your day in
heaven. Yeah.
You know, it's awesome. But if you're not a race fan,
you will be when
you're
leaving.
Not impressed just by the details and what all he say, then you've got a problem. Because I've been in a lot of museums, you know, different kinds, and this is one of the nicest of any kind, you know. So yeah, if you're not a race fan, still you need to come just to check it out. Check out the Manitrons. And
sure.
Every car's got a Manitron in front of it. You know, it's got three or four or five stories about it. So yeah, this place is phenomenal.
Well, you know, and the other thing is the Winston Cup Series has become almost like a legendary, Elvis-style thing. When you win that, you become like the Elvis of racing, you know. And now, Mark Martin won that the first time win.
Oh, you're catching me off guard. I should have read some notes.
I think it was 89, I think, if I remember right. Just
I
going off the first
I think you know a lot more than me. That's,
okay. Better. But, you know, since he won that, do we know how many times he won? Do you know that?
No.
He's been in the race game for so many years that it's under.
He's got him 30 good years in, you know, and it's time for him to walk away and do something different.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm looking at these little cars, and I'm thinking I'd be claustrophobic. Well, I know you would, too. We ain't built for this racing business.
Well, they got to have a bigger door.
I'm telling you. Mooney, thank you for your time. Thank you for showing me and Laura around.
Thanks for coming.
This has been wonderful. And don't forget, folks, if you want to see the best in racing, come right here to Mark Martin Ford, right between Southside and Batesville on 167. And I bet even Mooney will come out of his office and say hi to you. What do you think?
You bet we will. We're friendly bunch.
Now is the time to start planning your vacation getaway and see the sights of the natural state. Visit OzarkGateway.com for your free vacation planner. From relaxing fishing trips and fun on the lake, state parks and historic sites, to exciting festivals, cultural venues and events, museums, caves and caverns, there's something for every member of the family. Visit OzarkGateway.com for your free visitor's guide today. Ozark Gateway, great vacations at affordable prices.
Hi, I'm Joe Williams. I'm the Executive Director of Main Street Batesville. And you guys basically wanted to know about what Main Street Batesville is all about. We are entirely about the renovation of our Main Street and downtown area. The fact of the matter is, majority of downtowns and small communities all around the United States are falling apart because they are basing themselves as still the center of economic resources for a town for just about every single place. But if you go to many of these towns, you see that they are dilapidated, they're in need of repair, and they're in real need of restructuring because, as we all know, the economy has changed. The majority of your main businesses are on the outskirts of towns. Your big box businesses like Walmart, you get the idea. But the idea that we actually work upon is trying to restructure our downtowns and revamp them into a new format. In a sense, we try to redo the landscape around it, trying to make it more green and friendly for people to come down and really enjoy it as a community, which is the whole entire purpose of Main Street. Main Street, for the modern age, needs to be a community center, a place where all people can come, gather, enjoy themselves, walk around the shade, get your exercise, and be a hub of private businesses, businesses that can actually come, start up themselves, and be able to be self-sustaining. One, the concept of that also is to unite a commercial with residential. So that isn't our entire business right now, is we're actually trying to redo our streetscape in order to emphasize those structures, to make it more easier for cars to come down, to really slow down and enjoy the environment, to put in more green trees, more greenery, to allow people to really want to come around, walk around, enjoy themselves, and really, really just appreciate what we have there. And by doing that, making it a little more beautiful, making it a little more eye-appealing, you get the businesses that you want to actually come into your Main Street, which makes it self-sustaining. And that's sort of our concept that we're trying to do.
What's your favorite thing about living in Batesville?
My wife. That's a cheap plug, but you know what? I'm going to play it safe. No, I like the community in general. It's really interesting for a town this size to have as much stuff as it really does. I mean, we have a film festival, we have the Highland Games, which is why I'm wearing a kilt. It's the whole entire conversation of that, you know. There's so much stuff always going on. We have different music acts that come through here and then with everything else. It's just a nice hodgepodge of multiple people that really sort of emphasize, you know, what makes it really unique. Plus, you know, it really is just a nice, quiet town that really helps you grow, I think. I travel around enough, I used to at least. I've seen plenty of smaller towns that I understand the concept of itself. I think the main thing that Batesville has going for itself is the fact that we don't have an interstate that goes right through it. For most of the time, for a lot of smaller towns, that's kind of a death blow to a lot of them, because most people just think of getting on the interstate, going 30 minutes to someplace else, and doing that. But I believe since we're a little bit off the beaten path itself, and in the middle, at the very beginning of the Ozark Mountains and the foothills, it really gives it sort of a nice feel to it. You get sort of that mountain feel, but at the same time, it's got a river going straight through it. So we do get the little bit of a river fun that we always do enjoy, people do enjoy. And it's just a great collaboration of multiple things. So when I actually moved here last year, just my whole premise was kind of soaking in and realizing, it's like, oh, this just has a nice little collection of all these little things that helps it thrive.
Civil War Room of the Old Independence Regional Museum here with Miss Twyla Wright.
Yes, Twyla is the most knowledgeable person about this place.
Well, of course.
Or at least the one that's here, right? Twyla, tell us a little bit about this room. Won an award recently.
This exhibit did, from the Arkansas Museum Association.
Wow.
And it won Best Nominated in the state.
And that's right here in Batesville. People,
yes.
We need to make sure people know that, because a lot of people don't know the things we've been finding today are fabulous, and this is certainly one of them. You know, there's a lot of Civil War history, both made up and real, in our area, because we know a lot of people like to tell a lot of stories. But you actually have a great deal of knowledge just by looking at these artifacts. Now, tell me a little bit about Independence County's involvement in the Civil War. You said it was basically, it was Union and Confederate.
Sure. Yeah, one neighbor might be Union, another Confederate. So the misconception that all of this area was a Confederate. It is a misconception.
Not true.
It's not true.
What are some of the bigger battles? Like we talked about, mostly skirmishes here, but I know that Bethesda had a pretty big. They had kind of a big skirmish on a pond over there. I think is a pretty big story.
Yes. Uh huh. I am at Bethesda, and they had one at a pond out there, and there were some people killed.
Yeah, that was actually one where we lost life around here. Yeah,
that's right.
Well, because I know that there wasn't a lot of loss of life here. It was mostly just shooting at each other and keep running.
And a lot of guerrilla action.
Yeah.
And that was the real terrible, terrible mess. Not because there were big battles, we were talking about skirmishes, but also because you had Jayhawkers, you had guerrillas. Jayhawkers and bushwhackers, and they just terrorized the whole area. And both Confederate Shelby and others said, we've got to stop this. So when they came in and just stole everything that a family had, and it left a lot of women that had to take care of everything.
Because their men were killed.
The men were killed, sometimes right by bushwhackers, right in the yard.
Wow.
And so this was a lawless, lawless area.
And you know, that's why museums in the area that have anything like this, this is very important to our history.
Uh-huh.
And we talked about it, was only 4 years. People look at the Civil War and think that must have been forever. It was 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
Our presidents are elected for 4 years at a time, so that's the length of time that the North fought the South.
Mm-hmm.
And now you have all the artifacts here were donated by local folks, or they were taken from other places in the United States?
No, that's all local here.
All local.
We opened in 1998.
Mm-hmm.
To the public.
Okay.
So our 16th year here, and we have most of our preservation areas are almost full, so people are eager to give.
That's awesome.
So we got weapons here that came to us through an estate.
And you have cannonballs, you have small musket balls, you have handmade stone fillings for rifles and stuff.
Right.
I mean, it's just amazing all the things that I see in it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we have a new exhibit going in, which by the time people see this, it will be out there. So you want to tell us about that?
And it's going to last 6 weeks.
Okay.
But this is the Hugo and Gainey Preller House of Light exhibit.
Mm-hmm.
And that focused around Augusta. That is, a couple before the turn of the century came down on a floating photographic boat.
Wow.
And it was sails. And they came down the Mississippi, up the White River, got to Augusta and said, let's stop right here and start taking photographs of people, portraits. And so, lo and behold, the fellow who's putting it up now found the granddaughter. She's old now. And they found hundreds and hundreds of glass negatives, you know, early form of photography.
Wow.
And so they have now enlarged them, so they're big panels. We're going to have a grand time telling the story of the Prellers.
Can you tell folks how to find you guys? Are you on the? I'm sure you're on the internet.
Yes, we are. And if you're coming into town, you want to come 167.
Mm-hmm.
From one way or another, and then you'll see our signs, but from St. Louis Street, which is the main drag, then it's just about two blocks off there on the corner of 9th and Vine Streets.
Great.
Big stone building.
Can't miss it.
Right.
It looks like an old nunnery or something. Does this building have a history?
It wasn't a nunnery. No, it's men.
Old men. Tell us the story of the building, because it really looks neat.
Yeah. This is called Military Gothic. It's on the National Register of Places. And this was a National Guard armory.
Wow.
And it was done about 1935-36. And so we were able to get that from the owners. And
can you give us a phone number they can reach you at?
Our phone number here is 870-793-2121.
That's easy.
Yeah.
793-2121. I can make a jingle about that.
Yeah,
you probably could.
So please call us. Please come. We're excited.
A very modest admission fee. Very
modest. Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, it's really awesome. Twyla, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
I know we've enjoyed the whole day here with you.
Yeah.
And folks, if you want to come back out and see this place, you really need to do so. This room alone is worth the admission fee, I'm telling you.
Absolutely.
And that is the Old Independence Regional Museum
right
here in Batesville.
Right.
Twyla, thank you so much.
Okay.
Now is the time to start planning your vacation getaway and see the sights of the natural state. Visit OzarkGateway.com for your free vacation planner. From relaxing fishing trips and fun on the lake, state parks and historic sites, to exciting festivals, cultural venues and events, museums, caves and caverns, there's something for every member of the family. Visit OzarkGateway.com for your free visitor's guide today. Ozark Gateway, great vacations at affordable prices.
One thing's for sure, if there's food in the town, Doug and I can find it.
Well, Doug, I think we've officially found every use for an Old Depot.
That's right, and you know, right here in Batesville is one of the finest restaurants. This is a great use because there's food here.
I love it.
Yeah. Now, this is Fox Creek Barbecue, but you know, before that, a friend of mine named Danny Dozier had this place. It was called the Depot Diner. And my other good friend, Bill Dom, he came in here and remade this into a fantastic restaurant. And I understand that there's going to be a new owner, and we're going to talk to him too. His name is Chris Anderson. Yeah, Chris Anderson.
Chris Anderson.
So I tell you what, let's do. Let's not wait anymore. Let's go get our grub on. What do you think?
I'm all for that.
All right.
Well, I think we're going to have to wait a little bit on our barbecue.
Yeah, we got to take care of business first.
Let's do that first.
Who you got over there?
I have Bill Dom.
That's right. Bill Dom, yes. Yes. Very, Dom. Very good. And Chris Anderson.
And Chris Anderson.
And there's a reason why Chris is sitting here with us. This is kind of a unique day because I've known Bill for 15 years at least. Bill's the first guy I know that put slaw on my barbecue. Because when I came here from Texas, I'd never heard of such a thing.
Me either.
It's really, you're going to have it today. It's
all
really
right.
Good. Bill, tell us a little bit about your place here.
Well, you know, I was in the trailer and done festivals all those years, you know, that you knew me, and I had a trailer over here on between Taco Bell and McDonald's for two or three years. And so I decided to get off the street and get inside, and I found this train depot, and it was a unique place, and it'd been... It had first been renovated in the 90s by Danny Dozier.
That's what I said. Danny had the first restaurant.
He had it. It's called the Depot Diner. Mm-hmm. And then he went on to other things, and it stayed dormant for a while. And then I got it and refurbished it kind of. Didn't do anything to the work Danny did. He did all this nice good work. And then we built a kitchen and opened it as Fox Creek Barbecue. Fox Creek was my trailer, you know. My barbecue name for a long time.
Best barbecue in the country. I mean, that's, to me, Arkansas barbecue begins in Bill Dom. Sorry. But now we got a new guy in the trade.
Yeah. Now, my mentor in I always have to say this, in barbecue was Dr. Jim Stalker, who was well known in this country for barbecue. And he taught me and Chris a lot of guys how to cook barbecue.
So now you guys are about to trade hands here.
Yes, we are.
Bill's going to retire.
Chris has purchased Fox Creek, name, his recipes, everything. Now, even my smoke.
Now, Chris, you're going to keep things pretty much
absolutely,
like Bill has.
Absolutely. Bill and I go back a long way, and we've actually competed together in a couple of different teams in the barbecue circuit. And so I know... a lot of what he does. He's still got a few secrets he's yet to pass off, but we'll get those. And yes, everything's going to remain the same. The entertainment, the great barbecue.
Well, they have great live music here.
Oh yeah, we
I
do.
I should say, I saw the stage over there. Yeah. It looks absolutely fantastic.
Oh yeah, the whole place is ready to go. You know, Danny is an excellent guitar player.
We'll have Penny Wolf in here tonight, and have Andy Bushman and
Randy Morrison.
Randy Morrison in here tomorrow night, and then next week John. Coming in here with
John Parks
with his sister.
Yeah.
And then later on, of course, Sarah and John will be in here. We have good entertainment here.
Every
Friday, Saturday night.
You know, Batesville has a rich entertainment history that a lot of people don't know. And Sarah Joe, Danny Dozier, all these folks keep Batesville hopping.
Yeah.
And keep it dancing.
And they love to come here and play on the stage because we have a good audience, and it's the acoustics in here are great.
Yeah.
Got to get you down here sometime.
You know, I keep threatening to come, you know. But, of course, you know, today I'm doing TV. I'm not doing music.
Yeah. Well, I just...
I kick a little bit. I play a little bit of music.
Yeah, he does.
Now, Chris, let us know what the hours are going to stay the same. The phone number is going to stay the same.
Absolutely.
The website, the Facebook.
Absolutely.
So if people want to find you guys on Facebook, how do they do that?
Fox Creek Barbecue.
Mm-hmm. And if they want to find you, do you have foxcreekbarbecue.com?
Yeah.
Okay. And how hard would it be if I bribed you to get a recipe for your hot sauce?
Not.
Just cook. Probably ain't enough money. Like, probably already sold it to Chris is what you did. I know you right.
You know, the stack of papers I had to sign to keep that a secret.
Well, we're about to do some barbecue, and I'm going to have the famous hot sauce, and you're going to get some slaw on your...
I'm kind of hungry, so let's get to that.
Yeah, we'll just get through this, and we want to thank you guys for taking this time.
Thank you, Doug.
We wish you many, many years of success.
We appreciate you very much.
Bill, are you going to sing some later?
Oh, I don't know. We're going to try to talk him into it.
We need to do that. Okay, folks, we'll be right back with Discover Arkansas's Ozark Gateway Region. Friday night in Batesville, Arkansas, and as promised, here we are at the Batesville Motor Speedway. The crowd is excited, and the night is lit up with some great racing action. So we're going to take you down to the infield and show you what it's all about. But right now, let's watch a great race. Discover Arkansas, Ozark Gateway Region, paid for by a combination of state and Ozark Gateway Region funds.
At the end of the day, right where it all started.
That's right. It all started right here on the banks and in the White River, folks. But you know something? In the early 1900s, they built this series of locks and dams where you hear the water rolling.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of ended the river traffic as we know it, but it did not end this beautiful place we now know as Independence County.
Right.
Batesville, Arkansas. What a beautiful place.
It has been absolutely gorgeous, and the people here are wonderful, too.
Oh, yeah, they're great. I enjoyed the Mark Martin Museum. Mm-hmm. I enjoyed the old Independence Heritage Museum. Is
that
awesome?
That was a lot of information.
Yeah, it really was. Yeah. I think I could spend another day here and still not see it all.
I think that's accurate. I could, too.
Well, folks, join us next time right here on Discover Arkansas, Ozark Gateway Region. We're going to have a great time, and we hope to see you then. Bye-bye.